You can take footage from any camera and make it look beautiful. There's a ton of different factors that are needed to make your videos the highest quality possible. But today I'm gonna go over just one of my favorite steps, which is color grading. We just got back from doing some commission work down in Florida, and I was blown away by some of the tones I was able to pull out in some of the images. And if you missed those videos, they'll be linked below, or you can click up here at the top of the screen. So after we got back and after spending the time editing the footage that I got, I wanted to make a preset available that was inspired by the last part of our trip. We got a bunch of teals and deep greens and really cool blues, deep oranges, and I just love it. So today we're gonna be working with the South Florida LUT that I have available on my site. And I'm just gonna walk you through my workflow to hopefully improve some footage of your own. Without further ado, I'm gonna get started here in Final Cut Pro. As most people work in Final Cut Pro, I used to, I've switched over to Premiere, so bear with me, this is my first time even working in this. So first off, in order to work with the LUT in Final Cut Pro, you actually have to download a plugin from Pixel Film Studios. They have a free download, it's really nice. You just go through the site and everything, and then they send you an email and it gives you all the download instructions. Yeah, just go check out their site for the plugin. So once that's done and you have your footage loaded into your timeline, you're gonna go to your effects and apply that plugin. So over here, we're gonna have the LUT loader, and I guess we'll kind of get started here. So I'm gonna go to a frame. This is from drone shots that I got in Fort Lauderdale. Really great stuff. Let's see, I'm gonna try to get like a beach shot because I really like the colors there. Those are cool. I'm gonna go with this right now. So what you're gonna do, once you have the LUT loader applied, click on choose external LUT. So if you take a look, we're gonna apply the South Florida LUT, and if you watch the footage, you're instantly gonna see a change here. There we go. It's a little bit more vibrant. Now, I've never color graded in Final Cut Pro, so bear with me here. Brightness, gamma. Okay, so it's all your basics. I don't see any tone curves or anything. Oh, that's cool. I guess you can change the strength of the LUT, I guess. But yeah, you can pretty much just play around in here and get the look that you're going for. If you're maybe make it a little bit more contrasty. And then I guess they have split toning too, where you can mess with that. I don't know. So that's one way how you can apply and work with that. I mean, you can play around with these things, these sliders. Oh, that's kind of cool. Until you get the look that you want. So it's basically, I'm gonna have one with it on and one not. Crop? Is that a thing? No? Oh, crop, it's already on there. We'll do it like a half crop. That's the difference right here in your LUTs. How do you make the, oh, full screen. Nice. So obviously the bottom is gonna be your ungraded footage and the top is going to be what the LUT looks like, which is pretty nice. Actually, that's a lot better than what I thought it would be for Final Cut Pro, so. Now I'm gonna open up Premiere. This is more what I'm familiar with, so you have a lot more control over everything. So without further ado, let's go ahead and get started here. Once you have your project up, your footage in to Premiere, I go over to the color panel. I don't know if yours looks like this. This is what mine looks like. Everything's customizable here. As far as your workflow, what I'm gonna do is import the South Florida LUT. And there we have it. So that's a good starting point. I really like the way that these blues up here look. Up here in the corner with those oranges, like it's just beautiful, really film inspired. Now generally, what I'll do is I'll look at my scopes. If you don't know how to really read scopes or anything. There's videos on that. That's for a different segment. I'll set up a few points under the curves panel. I don't like my blacks to be at absolutely zero, and I don't like my whites to be clipping those. So I'll usually, maybe just a little. I'm screen recording, so everything's lagging. You can play around with this and get more or less what curves are. It's basically all these settings right here, but you have a little bit more control over exactly what you're looking for. Anyways, I guess that looks roughly good. What's really cool is in this, you can actually pull out specific colors. So for instance, this teal here, if I wanted to make that more teal without blowing out the rest of the image, I can just pull these up and you're instantly gonna see some more saturation in that, versus like there's other areas where I could bring it completely down. So I mean, for the sake of it, let's just take these greens and bring those out. I mean, why you would ever want to do this, I don't know, but it's just for the sake of, you can do it. You can see little changes there. I mean, I guess you could even do selective color. Again, I don't know why you'd want to do it, but it's just an example of you have control over everything. So here's some of the footage that I actually color corrected with this preset that I was really happy with. Now, it's really easy to make South Florida look sweet when you have a custom preset for it, and I've edited for it. But now taking this preset into real world, day-to-day scenes or whatever you're filming. For this case, I tried to be the most realistic as far as what people have. So I actually shot on an iPhone, Rebel T6i, and then just a point and shoot. All right, for the sake of this demonstration, I'm gonna be using the Canon Rebel T6i. The settings, really, you just go into picture style on this one. I tweak them a little bit. I usually take the sharpness down, the contrast down, and then the saturation pretty far down, maybe not that much. I still want a little bit left in the image. Unless you're shooting raw, which is a totally different, just your standard entry level DSLR. And then I'm also gonna be using a point and shoot. Tweaking. They're made to play around with. Every shot's gonna be different. It's also kind of important how your camera shoots, how flat it shoots, or it shoots a little bit too flat. Just doing some sample tests before you go out and actually shoot something for real, and figure out your sweet spot of what works for you. So like I said, this preset, as well as a couple others, are available now on my website, where you can kind of play around with it. And yeah, it's really cool that, I guess, Final Cut Pro has the ability to even work with these too. Back when I edited on it, it didn't have that, so I think that's pretty sweet. They're a lot of fun to play around with, whether you're a professional or just kind of farting around on your own, uploading your videos to YouTube. It really gives it this sweet look that I personally think is the most satisfying part of the whole film and photography process, is getting those colors and getting images that you are really proud of, and something signature to your own unique look. This video was a long time coming. I've had the question of what my workflow is and stuff like that, and there might be more in the future, just a little bit more detailed, but That was kind of a crash course in how I color grade.